Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. Because a few of you have requested it, I am making a recipe for turmeric milk for you. This recipe will help with pain in the body in general, but if you're struggling with menstrual pain, turmeric milk will help. It's very alkalizing. It moves acid out of the body so that the pain goes away. So here's how to make it. We're making about a liter and a half. That is a quart plus 16 ounces. And you start with, so that's 6 cups of water, about 6 1/4 cups of water. Then we've got 2 thumbs of turmeric. Have made it with more. It's just too strong. You can build up to more if you would like, but 2 is just fine. I have 4 deglet dates, or you can use 2 mejooled dates, or you can choose to leave this out. I add this for just a little bit of sweetness. It takes the bite out of the turmeric. And then I have 1 full cup of organic hemp seeds. I have made this with non-organic hemp seeds and it was just fine as well. But hemp seeds have your omega-3s if you're worried about that. But also, they are very alkalinizing. It is the most alkaline milk that I have ever made. People often ask me which milk I prefer, and hemp is my favorite. But we're going to start off by adding all of the water to the blender. You can use any blender, and of course, I love my Vitamix blender. I will never stop talking about how great the blender is because I know how many blenders I blew out before I actually bought this one. But living this lifestyle, you kind of have to have good tools, and I understand not being able to afford them at first, but you can save your pennies. All that money that you use for things that you don't need, put the money aside and buy something that is going to be an investment in your health. Next, we're adding the hemp seeds, then we're adding the deglet dates, and then we're adding the turmeric to the blender. Then all you do is blend the mixture on high for under 30 seconds. It depends on what kind of blender you have, but you want to blend it until everything is broken down and smooth. Next is the hardest part of the process, and it's not hard. It's just you have to strain the liquid from the pulp, and you need a fine mesh strainer for that and something to catch the liquid in. Fine mesh strainer came with the first juicer I ever bought, which was the Champion juicer, and I still have it. I don't use it because I like my Green Star, and I invested in a large measuring cup, and this one holds about 10 cups. And all you do is you pour the liquid from the pitcher into the strainer to separate the pulp from the liquid. That's all you do. And there you have your milk. You let it strain out. Sometimes you have to empty out the strainer, kind of rinse it, and then start again. Because sometimes the holes get blocked, so you have to unblock the holes. You see how it's coming out slow? So what I end up doing is pouring it back into the Vitamix, and then I go over to the sink and just kind of hit. You see what I did? I barely was able to show it on camera, but I think you get the point. And then you continue straining until all of your milk is strained. Then you clean up after yourself because you do not want to leave a mess in the kitchen. And there you have your milk. And then you see those 2 little jars behind the glass container? Well, that's what I'm going to store the milk in. And that's what the milk looks like. It's just slightly golden. Or yellow, sort of, orangey yellow, I guess. And it's so thick and creamy. It tastes really, really good. Also, play with the recipe because you may want it sweeter or you might not want it sweet at all. You can also add other things into this recipe like ginger. But there you have it, my turmeric milk recipe for pain in the body. Let me tell you, it helps. It helps, I'm telling you. If you drink it on a regular basis, you don't even have to drink the whole container. Just drink, 16 ounces in a day, and it lasts for about 3 days in a refrigerator. But if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, y'all, take care.